A new note on stories with an impact, that is, stories that I come across, sometimes I've been told this, I think I started with the story of the dog, and New Year's Eve, heard in the sauna of all places, but now I'm thinking, after mentioning earlier on the case of Rosa Luxemburg, or Luxembourg, I'm thinking of Luis Ramirez, or Luis Ramirez, depending on how he used to how he pronounces his own name. Only he's a fictional character, someone said more. My favorite author of all time, with Proust, he's there in the top five, Thomas Mann. Well, the list is getting longer than five, of course, because I've been finding wonderful American authors, modern, Cheever, Flannery O'Connor, Bernard Malamud, and quite a few others. Catherine Ann Porter, I love her short stories that I'm reading now. And Raymond Carver. Anyway, so in this short story by Somerset Maugham, we have the character of Luis Ramirez, who is a happy man. And with this, I came to the conclusion I might just well end the note here and say, well, you have it. This is a story with an impact. I've read about a happy man. What makes this intriguing and more special is the fact that he is a prisoner and he's happy. So, already an important message there. You can be in dire straits, you can have difficult outside circumstances and still overcome. In fact, coming back to the happiness pie, 50% of our happiness-based level, our inclination to be happy, is predetermined by genes. There are people who were born with a tendency to be more positive, optimistic, and hence happier. And there are those who are born with the other predilection. They prefer to be gloomy, negative, and therefore unhappy. I think I was in the a bit negative, even if I regret I didn't come across this positive psychology some 20 years ago, when I was just 10. I'm kidding, humor is part of the recipe. Plus, Alan Langer at Harvard discovered that if we plunge into the past 20 years back and we think in terms of youth, and we can get there. And there are other tests which confirm that. When people are primed with things like and words like, just words have an impact. Florida, gray, slowly, they react as if they were older. And the reverse is true in other contexts. But trying to return, 50% are predetermined, 10% depend on circumstances outside. If you're in Somalia, there's a famine now. South Sudan, same. Syria, we all know. You can be in the White House, and then that's bad, because you have a guy there who's rich and powerful, the most powerful, could be argued, on Earth, and still he's grumpy, and a grumpy old man. Spied on by Obama, he just said this morning. Every day he has something to complain and be unhappy about. There's the opposite. There's Luis Ramirez at the end of the world, by the way. He is in a place, he was sentenced, and he was a French detainee, if I'm not wrong, and sent at the end of the world, and he's a prisoner. It's true, he's a prisoner who is involved in executing people, so he's an executioner, cherry on top. To add insult to injury, this is a job which could make anybody depressive and suicidal. But he's happy, it's true, he has the small garden hoe, so he's grateful for what he has. He's taking advantage of what he has, and he's happy with that. He's cherishing the weather, whatever there is to cherish. And it sends me also back to the message sent by Fyodor Dostoevsky, who has been sentenced to death, and he has 3 minutes. I will not get into the details of that because there's a note in this series of stories with an impact on myself. Note 5 or thereabouts is dedicated to Dostoevsky and that 3 minutes. But anyway, here I will just emphasize the message. When you see life at the end, you're at the end of it, you have minutes or a day when one is sentenced to death, which was his case. He's loving every minute, every moment of it. It's so intense. And from here, you need to understand carpe diem. Live your every day like it's your last. Don't waste time. Also, Seneca said, we complain we don't have time. Oh, we don't have time, and but then we waste so much. And it, the question is, life is not short, as we appreciate when we reach an old age. It's long enough. It's just that we waste it. We treat time as a resource without too much value, alas.